So Sony just released the A6400. It's a mirrorless camera, it's with a crop sensor, and it's pricey, $1,000, not cheap. So in this video, I'm gonna tell you who is it for, whether you should go for the A6400 or not, what are the good things about the A6400, what are the bad things about A6400. Let's start. So Sony already have a A6300 and A6500. I already have a A6500 since last 2 years. I use it for my overhead camera and all the small B-rolls whenever I'm traveling. So A6400 is something, a camera which is in between A6300 and A6500. If you already have a A6500, you do not need to get A6400. If you have a A6300, 6400 is going to be an incremental upgrade for sure. So this is not something like a hybrid camera. I mean, you can do pretty much everything. It does 4K, it does 120fps, it does 100fps, it does S-Log, S-Log 3, S-Log 2, almost does everything what a normal $3,000 camera, Sony full frame A7S II, A7R III does. But it's a crop sensor, so that's the reason it's like $1,000, while the A7R III and S2 is like $2,500 or $3,000. So this is basically a camera which is Sony pointing it or making it towards for the vloggers. So this small, tiny, you can basically just put a gorilla pod, or you can even hold it to your hands with a small mic and just get started and get done with the vlogging. So this is basically a vlogging camera. So who is it for? A640 is basically for the vloggers out there, or people who do not have a camera, any camera, and they just want to have a mirrorless camera or a small portable camera which can just throw it to their back and use it for any kind of photos, videos, or anything. It also does time lapses, inbuilt time lapses. You do not need to install more applications, you do not need more other gear or rig it up. You can just use the time lapse function and get some nice time lapses with the camera. So basically, it's targeted for the people who need some quick shots, videos, photos, vlogging. It does almost everything. So basically, this is a camera which is pointing or is for the market for the vloggers actually. Now, whether you should go for this A6400 or not? Absolutely yes. If you do not have A6300, A6500, and you do not want to invest on a high-end full-frame camera of Sony, you can just go ahead and get this camera. This does pretty good low-light shots as well. This does 120fps, 4K, almost does everything what a normal Sony high-end camera does. So basically, it makes sense because it has some nice features which I'm just going to discuss right now, and it's going to make your mind up to go ahead and get this camera. First, the good things, the pros. As per Sony, this is their one of the best autofocusing, fastest autofocusing camera they have ever made. I guess they're actually marketing it as more faster than, I mean, the AF is faster than A7R III as well, like 0.02 seconds, while the Sony A7R III is like 0.03. It doesn't make a lot of difference, but still, as per Sony, this is the fastest autofocusing camera they have ever made. Second, the touch autofocus. So basically, you can just touch and have the focus get locked to that until and unless you again touch it back and get the touch focus out. So this is again massive. We have this feature in A7R III. I have been using it for a lot of times in my videos. Absolutely works insane. So this feature you are going to now get in a $1,000 Sony mirrorless camera. How nice is that? Third, the flip up screen. Finally, we have a flip up screen like the Sony RX series on the Sony Alpha 6400. So you can now even see the composition while vlogging, see your face, how it's composed, and do those nice vlogging shots or the pictures where you normally want to see yourself. So this flip up screen is absolutely a game changer for A6400. Fourth, limitless video recording. For A7S III, A7S II, there is normally a limit of 30 minutes for any kind of video recording. But for this A6400, there is absolutely no limit. If you are doing a documentary film or an interview, you can just keep the record on and you can just keep on recording until and unless you are like going to finish your card. So this has got no limit for A6400. This is again nice for, because I know a lot of people who keep on doing a lot of hacks on their Sony Alpha cameras just to get that limit out. Fifth, the real-time IFF. This is nice. I just cannot wait to get this feature on my Sony A7R III. I just hope they are going to put that update in the next firmware upgrade. So this thing is nice. So basically, while you are doing pictures or videos, this camera is going to keep on tracking your eye. I mean the subject's eye. This is nice. For A7R III, normally we have to keep on selecting the IAF to get the picture, get the eye on the tracking, but that only works for the video. It doesn't work for the photos, but this time A6400 also works for the photos. Now the bad things. First, no eyepiece. I cannot believe this. I mean, Sony people have been on drugs. No eyepiece on a camera which you are targeting for the vloggers. How stupid is that? How can you just put a camera out for the vloggers without eyepiece? I mean, 99% of vloggers use a camera on a gorilla pod, and if you do not have the eyepiece, it's going to be lot of movement. I mean, without eyepiece, I cannot even think of vlogging. So not sure why Sony did not add the eyepiece. Maybe that because we already have the eyepiece on A6500, which is like 3 years old camera, while this is the latest camera, you do not put an eyepiece. That is pretty ridiculous. Second, the flip-up screen position, that is crap. I mean, if you have a camera with a flip-up screen and if you are putting a mic on the top of it, basically you are just blocking off the complete screen. You should have basically made a screen completely slip off, like a Canon or a Nikon or a Panasonic GH5 actually swivels out the complete screen and you can see the screen. For a flip-up screen, if you are putting a mic on the top of it, the complete screen is blocked. I don't know what's the logic of putting a flip-up screen just for the having the idea of exclusivity, but this actually sounds and looks stupid. You cannot have a flip-up screen for the vloggers. And as per Sony, they are putting a small jack out of the camera for the side mounting of the mic. Again, if you are targeting a small camera for the vloggers with the screen up, no one wants to add one more rig to get the mic attached to the camera. This is again going to add up a lot of space, add up a lot of weight to the whole rig, and it's not going to happen. So the flip-up screen position is kind of bad. I just hope they do not put this same flip-up screen in the A7 S3, for which I'm actually waiting for. Third, the price is way too high. For $1,000 for A6400 body, that is not even a full-frame sensor. I guess $1,000 is pretty hard for the consumer cameras or the consumers. So basically, it should be somewhere around $500 or $600. For $1,000 in India, it's going to be close to a lakh or even more. For $1,000 without eyepiece, with a flip-up screen without eyepiece, it's not going to happen. I just feel the price is way too high for the Indian market, the normal consumers. It should be somewhere around $500-$600. That should be a sweet spot. I mean, pretty sweet spot for this camera. So I guess that's pretty much it, all the good things and bad things. But if you really want to go ahead and get the camera, you do not have a 6300, 6500, you do not want to spend like 2-3 lakhs on a Sony A7 R3 or A7 S2, this camera is the way to go. But if you can invest a little bit more, I would suggest to just go ahead and get the Sony A7 III. That's a full-frame camera and absolutely stellar box of piece. I mean, nice features, almost everything what you get in a Sony A7 R3, you are getting in a Sony A7 III. So, but if you're in budget, this thing makes sense. So if you've got any questions about Sony A6400, let me know in the comment section below. Smash the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay updated. I will see you in my next video.